In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Alleluia. Very warm welcome to our Eucharist of the fifth Sunday of Easter and for our 8 a.m. Eucharist. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Risen Christ, rising in glory, dispel the darkness of our hearts and minds. Lord, we have lived by our own strength and followed our own desires. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We have lived by the light of our own eyes, often faithless and not believing. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
We have lived for this world alone and doubted your love and forgiveness. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you. We give you thanks. We praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, form the minds of your faithful people, that we may love what you command and desire what you promise, so that amid the many changes of this world, our hearts may there be fixed where true joys are to be found, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for our first reading.
The first reading is from Acts chapter 11. Now the apostles and the believers who were in Judea heard that the Gentiles had also accepted the word of God. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem, the circumcised believers criticized him, saying, "Why did you go to uncircumcised men and eat with them?" Then Peter began to explain it to them step by step, saying, "I was in the city of Joppa praying, and in a trance I saw a vision. There was something like a large sheet coming down from heaven, being lowered by its four corners, and it came close to me. As I looked at it closely, I saw four-footed animals, beasts of prey, reptiles, and birds of the air. I also heard a voice saying to me, 'Get up, Peter, kill and eat.' But I replied, 'By no means, Lord, for nothing profane or unclean has ever entered my mouth.' But a second time the voice answered from heaven, 'What God has made clean, you must not call profane.' This happened three times. Then everything was pulled up again to heaven. At that very moment, three men sent to me from Caesarea arrived at the house where we were. The Spirit told me to go with them and not to make a distinction between them and us. These six brothers also accompanied me, and we entered the man's house. He told us how he had seen the angel standing in his house and saying, "Send to Joppa and bring Simon, who is called Peter. He will give you a message by which you and your entire household will be saved." And as I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell upon them, just as it had upon us at the beginning. And I remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said, "John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." If then God gave them the same gift that he gave us when we believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that I could hinder God? When they heard this, they were silenced, and they praised God, saying, "Then God has given even to the Gentiles the repentance that leads to life." For the word of the Lord, thanks be to God. The reading response from Psalm 148 is, "Alleluia, praise the Lord." Let the whole creation cry, "Glory to the Lord on high. Heaven and earth awake and sing. God is our eternal King. Alleluia, alleluia, praise the Lord." Men and women, young and old, raise the anthem manifold. Join with children's songs of praise. Worship God through length of days. Alleluia, alleluia, praise the Lord. Praise God, all you hosts above, ever shining forth in love. Sun and moon uplift your voice. Night and stars in God rejoice. Alleluia, alleluia, praise the Lord. From the north to southern pole, let the mighty chorus roll. Holy, holy, holy one. Glory be to God alone. Alleluia, alleluia, praise the Lord. The second reading is from Revelation chapter 21. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them as their God. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life." For the word of the Lord, thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. I give you a new commandment, says the Lord. Love one another as I have loved you. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. Hear the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you.